Hello everyone, welcome to another video. Today in this video I'm gonna just show you me rinsing the my old washer out. I just got done doing a video with doing some grunge stuff in here, so now as I always do, I'm gonna run a cycle with it empty, just so it gives it a chance so we can rinse the tub out. This is just a basic washing machine. Has no water level controls or temperature controls. It's all controlled through the dial. You can refer to that video if you want to know what. How all that works. On the extra heavy, you can get the hot water. The heavy will be warm water, normal cold, but as you move it up there, it gives you shorter cycles. Shortens the cycle. Okay, so now I'm gonna start the machine, push the knob in to be able to turn it. If you don't push it in, it just spins. As you can see, it just spins. Now I'm going to turn the dial over to here. This is a real-time video. I'm doing this with the lid open so you can see the machine work. I have a little screw in there just because it won't spin or drain unless that's pressed, and there's a little pin on the door, like right on the door, that pushes that. So I gotta warn everyone here that please don't try this if you're unfamiliar with your machine, because you could get hurt if you or someone sticks your hand in while it's running. So now I'm going to start the machine. Sometimes every couple of months I'll use some washer machine cleaner, but I don't use this washer very often, as it's only my grunge washer. I do all my main washing in my front load, which you've probably seen my videos of. Now we're just going to let it go through its cycle. There'll be a break at the 34-minute mark, because this is being recorded on an Android phone, and it breaks the video every 34 minutes on this video setting. I have to turn it back to a lower setting to be able to probably make it record longer, but I don't want to lose the high definition recording.
recorded the video at this angle because I was hoping that you could give me the chance to be able to also see the dial as it moves. It moves itself around, but then you can see how where it is for each cycle takes place. Yes, if anyone's curious, I have had all three of my washers going at one time before. I've had both the front load, had the pedestal washer and this washer all running at one time before.
If anybody's curious. Sure, this isn't going to be very interesting for a lot of people to see, but I know there's some out there that are interested in this kind of thing, and it's also helpful for those that are just learning how to do laundry and take care of their machines. No, I don't usually run the washer like this. I'm only doing it for demonstration purposes so you can actually see the washer work.
guess I should just mention that, no, I don't run all three very often, one time very often, but I can if I have to. Actually very rare that I'll run all three at the same time. Two, yes. Two. And that's usually the front load in my pedestal wash. But rarely three. But rarely all three at one time. Having three washers and two dryers running all at once. I know some will say, yeah, it's going to be hard on the water, it's going to be hard on the water bill and the electric bill, but in the end, it actually only equals out. Whether you do spread the load out between two washers and do it all in one, in the end, a lot of times it equals out. About the same. This particular washer is not an Energy Star certified washer. It's too old for that. This washer was made long before that stuff came around. This washer is at least 10 years old. We actually got this washer from my wife's ex. She'll bring the wash down, I'll run it through, and then take it up to her, and she folds and puts away. As you can see, there is still a little bit of sudsiness in there. That's one of the reasons why I always run after I'm finished with the wash round, round of wash, I always rinse up and run one round empty so that way the rinses out any residue that may be left in there. That way I don't get any get buildup as easily. This with my front load too. I always run the tub clean cycles on both of my washers. My pedestal washer has a tub clean cycle as well. one point this washer was doing laundry for 7 people. 5 of them being girls, women. 4 girls and my wife. At one point we had a friend living here with us. My girls have all grown up and have moved out. Now it's only my wife and I. Our friend wanted to go somewhere else. This washer has done a lot of laundry, and I'm surprised it runs as well as it does. It still does, considering how much laundry it's done over the last, over its lifetime. Goes to show how well things were built back in those days, that this thing was able to take all the abuse and it still runs and it doesn't make all kinds of weird noises. This whole bar, front load and lasts as long as this one did, has. I'm not going to get rid of this machine until it's completely dead. probably won't be making as many videos with this machine. And if you notice, it doesn't always run the same way every time either. Sometimes it'll, when it goes to drain, it'll spin while it's draining. Other times it won't. That's why I said in the other video, sometimes this machine is finicky and doesn't always run the same way twice. As you can see, this time while it's draining, it's not actually moving. Other times it will. Sides and how the clutches engage, whoever it is.
Now it's going to rinse. If you wanted to, you could probably just do the rinse and spin there, where it's at now. But when I'm finished, I usually like to put it up, let it run the whole cycle, so that way it uses hot water to be able to rinse everything out. Not only that, it helps to sterilize the tub a little bit. sorry, I don't know how well you could hear me over the machine. Just for the record, the rinse cycle on this washer is cold water. that's the end of rinsing the tub out. Very easy, very simple. Yeah, some may think it's wasting water, but at the same, but to me, it's keeping the tub clean and not allowing a lot of gunk and other garbage to build up in there over time. I hope you found this interesting and informative. Thank you for watching. God bless.